Yes guys, turn to question number 15. Summarize balance sheet of strong and weak as on 31st March 2012 is given to you. The balance sheet as on 31st March 2012 is there, but the first line below the balance sheet says strong limited will take over weak on 1st July 2012. That is after 6 months. No balance sheet is available on that date. It is however estimated that Weak Limited earns an estimated profit of 2 lakhs after charging a proportionate depreciation of 10% per annum on the fixed assets during April to June. That is how many? 3 months only. 3 months. April to June is only 3 months. Estimated profit of Strong Limited during these 3 months is 4 lakhs after charging a proportionate depreciation of 10% per annum on the fixed assets. 10% per annum for 3 months, it's basically 1/4, 2.5%. Both the companies have declared and paid 10% dividend within the 3 months period. Goodwill of Weak Limited is valued at 2 lakhs and fixed assets are valued at 1 lakh above the estimated book values. Guys, that is an adjustment for takeover. Goodwill and fixed assets are adjustments for takeover, not for the 6 months balance sheet. Purchase consideration is to be satisfied by Strong Limited by issue of shares at par, ignoring taxation. What are the number of shares to be issued? What is the net current assets of Strong and Weak? And what is the P&L of Strong Limited as on 1/7/2012? And find out what is the fixed assets on 1/7/2012, balance sheet on 1/7/2012 after takeover. Normally you solve the problem, all the bits questions will be satisfied. So go on. I don't have balance sheet for 3 months, so we have to prepare the balance sheet for 3 months. You don't have to prepare a Schedule 3 balance sheet. You can prepare a normal balance sheet since it's just a working note. Balance sheet as on 1st July. Go on. Two companies I have, one is strong and other one is weak. And on the balance sheet, the first one is equity share capital. 50 lakhs and 30 lakhs. Unchanged with the reserves. Four lakhs and 2 lakhs. P&L will change. We'll fill the amount later on. Just put a star mark. Take a working note and fill that up. There's no change suggested as far as your creditors is concerned. So I'll take the same values. 5 lakhs and 3 lakhs. Assets. Fixed assets will change. It should get depreciated by 2.5%. 10% per annum. This will be 29 lakhs, 25,000. 75,000 depreciation. That will be 19,50,000. 50,000 depreciation. Stock, debtors, no change. Copy down the values. 8 lakhs, 6 lakhs. 14 lakhs, 9 lakhs. Cash and bank balance, we have to calculate. Preliminary expenses. Just take down the values, whatever is there. 1,50,000. Cash and bank will normally take it as balancing figure. By preparing cash flow statement again. Get the P&L balance, you can write the cash as balancing figure. P&L as on 1/7/2012. Maintain two columns, strong and weak. Continue. Start with the balance as on 31st March 2012. Already given in the balance sheet is 6 lakhs and 4 lakhs. add P&L for 3 months, profits for 3 months, for weak is 2 lakhs, for strong is 4 lakhs. 4 lakhs and 2 lakhs. They are also paying dividend, less dividends. At the rate of 10%. 5 lakhs and 3 lakhs. 10% of the paid up share capital. I'll be left out with the profits of 5 lakhs and 3 lakhs. That's it. There's no nothing else as an adjustment given there. So you can place these values. Five lakhs and 3 lakhs, and you can fill up the cash. I think this is 11,75,000. Check the figure. I think this is 3 lakhs. Check your cash balances. Yes guys, how is the PC being distributed? Let's check. PC. Goodwill of weak is 2 lakhs. Fixed assets are valued 1 lakh more than the book value. PC is to be satisfied by strong limited by issue of shares at par. Oh, basically what we are trying to do is net assets method. Hit the PC with net assets method. Only take weak limited column. Issue price per share in strong is 10. Purchase consideration, net assets method. Come on, start with your assets. Fixed assets, what is the adjustment to fixed assets? Fixed assets are estimated to be 1 lakh more. 1 lakh add 20,50,000. Stock, any adjustment? No, only goodwill valuation is there. That's it. Balance, you can take book values. Stock, 6 lakhs. Debtors, 9 lakhs. Cash in bank, 3 lakhs. Do not forget, take goodwill. Goodwill is 2 lakhs. This is 40,50,000 total assets. Outside liabilities. Only one outside liability existing, creditors. 3 lakhs. PC is 37,50,000. Is discharging by issue of shares. Issue price per share is 10. At par, he said. Issue price per share in strong limited. Is it 10 or 100? Check. Face value of the share is not given. You wish. I'll take it as 10. Number of shares to be issued is 3,75,000. Identify nature of amalgamation and method of accounting. You revalued the fixed assets, you valued goodwill, sufficient enough information to call it as purchase. Nature of amalgamation, purchase. Method of accounting, purchase method. Don't calculate goodwill or capital reserve, not necessary. We have a rule, whenever your PC is calculated by net assets method and it is amalgamation by nature of purchase, the value of goodwill will be the same value which you have included in net asset valuation. So my goodwill for this purpose will be equal to whatever you have included in net assets valuation. How much? 2 lakhs. Straightforward for the balance sheet. When you are preparing the balance sheet, use the balance sheet that you have just prepared on 1-7, the draft balance sheet you have prepared, use that. Do not use that balance sheet which is given in the question, because that is 31st March balance sheet. I am trying to prepare a balance sheet on 1st July. Balance sheet of strong. As on 1-7-2012. Equity and liabilities. Shareholder funds, already existing share capital in strong is 50 plus now you have issued 37,50,000, so this total share capital will be 87,50,000. Reserves and surplus, it is purchased, so selling company reserves will not come. You have a reserve for 4 lakhs and a P&L for 5 lakhs. You have a preliminary expenses which should also be written with a negative sign. It's a negative reserve. Show it with a negative sign on the liability side. Schedule 3, you can't write these expenses on the liability side. Sorry, on the asset side. It should be under reserves and surplus only. The last liability is current liability. Current liabilities are creditors. Simple addition will give you 8 lakhs. Assets, non-current assets, under non-current assets, tangible fixed assets. What is already existing in the balance sheet of strong? 29,25,000. Plus what is taken over? Check your net assets taken over. 20,50,000. 20,50,000 plus 29,25,000 is 49,75,000. Intangible asset goodwill. Two lakhs. That's it. Rest all are current assets. Stock. Already existing 8 plus taken over 6, 14. Debtors. 14 plus 9, 23. Cash in bank. 11 lakh 75 plus 3 lakhs is 14 lakh 75. 1 crore 3 lakh 50 thousand is the balance sheet total. Yes, guys, go for the 16th. TNV proposed to amalgamate and their summarized balance sheets as on 31st March 2012 are as follows. So TNV Limited, there is some investments in T Limited having a face value of 3 lakhs yielding a 6% tax free. Okay, so they yield a return of 6% on 3 lakhs, that is 18,000, which is tax free. Net profit after tax of T Limited, V Limited are given to you for 3 years. That is for 2009-10, 10-11 and 11-12. Normal trading profits are considered to be 15% of the closing capital invested. Goodwill is taken as 4 years purchase of average super profits. The stock of T Limited and V Limited will be taken as 6,12,000 and 4,26,000 respectively for the purpose of amalgamation. For the purpose of amalgamation is something really important because that is not for the purpose of calculating goodwill. That's only for the purpose of amalgamation. W Limited is formed for the purpose of amalgamation of these two companies. Suggest a scheme for capitalization of shares and the ratio for exchange of shares between the companies. And draft an opening balance sheet of W Limited. So first value goodwill, then we'll go for purchase consideration. Both the companies are amalgamating, T and V, to form another company called as W. Gone first, valuation of goodwill. We need to start with FMP. Two companies, T Limited and V Limited. First start with average profits. There's no trend, you can take a simple average of those profits, 3,90,000, 3,75,000 and 4,50,000. So 4,05,000 for T and 1,41,000 for V. Do not forget less return on non-trade investments. Check the investments. Non-trade investments appearing in T Limited is 3 lakhs, yielding a return of tax-free. Tax-free at 6%, so you don't have to adjust for tax, directly 18,000 reduce. So this will give us 3,87,000. And 1,41,000, this is your FMP. To identify super profits, we need first closing capital employed. Normal trading profits are 15% is talking about. So find out closing capital employed multiplied by 15%. That will be your normal trading profits. Assets. Take one by one. First asset is your fixed assets. There's no revaluations that he's talking about. Just take the book values. That's it. Fixed assets are 12 lakhs and 3 lakhs. I can't take investments for the purpose of valuation of goodwill. They are non-trade investments. So I'll take stock. 6 lakhs and 3 lakhs, 90. Debtors, 5,10,000 and 1,80,000. Finally, your cash and bank balances, 90,000 and 30,000. Only one outside liability exists. That is creditors. That will give you closing capital employed. Come on. My total net assets are 24 lakhs and 9 lakhs. And your liabilities are 3 lakhs and 1,50,000. That'll give us 21 lakhs closing capital employed and 7,50,000 closing capital employed. NRR is taken as 15%. Already given to you 15% on closing capital employed itself. So for valuation of goodwill, I'll start with FMP. I already know these figures of 3,87,000 and 1,41,000. Compare this with normal profits. 15% on closing capital employed. Come on, 15% on the closing capital employed. 3,15,000. 7,15,000 into 50% is 1,12,500. Oh, we can identify super profit from this. 28,500. Goodwill can be taken as 4 years of purchase multiplied by 4, 2,88,000. 1,14,000. You have the value of goodwills then. There is no particular method which is given, so we have to follow net assets basis. Don't start from calculating all the net assets. You already have closing capital employed. You can use this figure. Purchase consideration by net assets method. Closing capital employed. ₹21,00,000 and ₹7,50,000. Add goodwills to this which you just calculated. 2,88,000 and 1,14,000. I did not consider investments. Non-trade investments not considered for the purpose of goodwill valuation. 3,00,000 and nil. One more adjustment exists because there is a change in the value of stock. Stock revaluations. How much did you take stock in the net assets? Stock I have taken as 6 lakhs. But the revalued figure is 6,12,000. Add just 12,000. 6 lakhs is already added. In the same way, how much did you add for the stock in V Limited? 3,90,000. Revalued figure is 4,26,000. 36,000 add. If there was a preference share capital, I would have deducted. But there is nothing like that. So you can straightforward go with the totals.
7 lakhs, 9 lakhs.
Settled by issue of shares in W Limited, you can take 10 rupees share. The ratio of exchange of shares between them is 3:1. Because net assets are 27 lakhs and 9 lakhs, they will exchange the ratios of shares in 3:1 ratio. Issue price per share in W is 10. That will give you number of shares to be issued. ₹2,70,000 and ₹90,000. Story ends there. So the ratio of exchange of shares is 3:1. He's asking you to draft a W Limited balance sheet. Go on with that.
balance sheet of W Limited. As on 31st March, or put it as 1/4/2012, equity and liabilities. Shareholders' funds. Share capital. Equity share capital. 27 lakhs plus 9 lakhs is 36 lakhs. Reserves and surplus, nothing. Current liabilities, add creditors, 4 lakh 50. Liability side total is 40 lakh 50. Assets, non-current assets, tangible fixed assets. You just have to add the tangible fixed assets, 15 lakhs. Intangible asset, goodwill. Goodwill is a total of these two. That should be 3 lakhs. No, it should be 4 lakhs 2000. Other non-current assets. Investments. 6% tax-free bonds, 3 lakhs. Come to the current assets. First one is stock. Revalued figures, 6 lakh 12 plus 4 lakh 26. 10 lakhs 38. Debtors, simple addition. 5 lakh 10 plus 1 lakh 90 is 6 lakhs 90. 1 lakh 80 plus 6, 5 lakh 10. Cash and bank balance is 1 lakh 20, 90,000 plus 30,000. I should again total to 40 lakh 50,000. That should tally the balance sheet, guys.